and sit down, we don't talk to the law. Yeah, they think I'm tripping, they listen. They know our every move, yeah, they want us all in prison. That's why I can't sleep at night until they get in. I'm on another mission, I'm just young and I'm living.
Yeah, I done seen the best stuff from Jando. 25 to life and they can't stop. Never met a man that they can't talk. We're talking on the phones, they can hear us.
7 in the morning and they in my home. My bank account's froze, what is going on? Why it all start going wrong?
Yeah. My soul still echo, the feds won't let go. Money never sleeps when you're the Black Gordon Gecko. Line looking like they waiting on the retro. Sixes, I feel special. Resale and I never pay retail. Money afforded me the spree wells. And that then courted me a V12. Avoid the phones if it's sounding like a seashell. Too much clicking in the connection. Connect the dots with my connect for my protection. Face to face, I place my like a drive-thru. Feeling, you know how I do, push.
I done seen the best of them, Jando. 25 to life and they can't stop. Never met a man that they can't talk. We're talking on the phones, they can hear us.
7 in the morning and they in my home. My bank account's froze, what is going on?
And hi again, everybody. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, when you and I were going through our final run-throughs at breakfast, we kept thinking, tonight we're going to get to see a couple of very good passing offenses.
And we're talking about both sides having multiple receivers that could have an impact on this game. It's not just one guy that's going to make all the plays. If you take him away, maybe number two, number three, they make the big plays that impact who wins the game.
This is taken at his 4. They'll bring it back to just about the 25. Call it the 24-yard line. Start the drive here with an end around. They find some open field here. And he's into the clear. The 30, 10, and touchdown. Randy Moss, 76 yards. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead. The very first play from scrimmage. How about that? Talk about setting a tone.
And people always talk about doing exactly that in the first 5 minutes of the game, the first offensive and defensive series. Who's going to gain an advantage? Well, we saw exactly what happened there. A tone was definitely set by the offensive team.
Gets fielded in the end zone. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Mariota now to throw on first down. They'll set up the screen here to Mixon. And he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. It's a loss of 5 there, bringing up second. Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on first down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see it break down as the passer, I think in this situation, you're throwing it at the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it off, or you throw it away, throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try and make a bigger play. There's really no one else running a pattern that should be open.
And he's going to be wrapped up and driven down. Clay Matthews in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. Second down, Mariota. He finds Randall Cobb with a completion. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. A nice pickup there, 19 yards. And they're set up better for third.
One, one, one.
third and one. Here's Mariota. Open man, it's Vernon Davis. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. His first catch, good for 9 and a first down. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
In the opening script, however, they drew it up for this first drive, going to plan so far. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
Mariota now on second down. Wide open receiver complete. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble. So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about. Getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. Exactly right. A lost opportunity.
No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal. They'll try to punch it in to Davis. And he's going to ball his way into the end zone for the Dolphins score. Terrell Davis taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Ryan Succop on for the point after. Extra point up and good by Succop. And we are tied at 7. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This one fielded at the 5. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. And now back out comes the offense. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in, because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue. They'll run for the first time with Mark Ingram. And he's brought down. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
That's a football play right there. That takes me back a little bit. Toss sweep to the right, get it to your back, get a lot of people out in front, control the line of scrimmage, wide receivers blocking downfield. It almost feels like half the crowd is in front of him, getting it down to the secondary. They have a tough time getting him down.
And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. On second down, here's Roethlisberger. Eluding the pressure right. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Anderson Dejo. And the return stops just a few yards shy of midfield. They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage, but instead he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
Mariota to throw it. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A nice gain of 21 yards. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run into a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter begins with the Dolphins in possession of the football. They've got it 2nd and 10 to start things out. the shotgun. It's Mariota. And he will find Davis. That's complete. And he'll go down at the 28. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
Mariota had an 87-yard run as a rookie. This one a bit less, but it is a first down. They go play action here on first down. He will find Davis on the left side, complete. The Dolphin passing game rolling here. They've got another first down.
In today's game, we talk a lot about space players, getting them out into the open field and getting the ball in their hands. Terrell Davis did that quite well during his career. Averaged nearly 3 catches per game at 8 yards per catch.
Mariota going to bring him up first and 10. And he's 8 for 8 now, throwing the ball to start the game. They'll give it to Nixon. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down. That's what they wanted out of that first down play. Run it down there. Now they're knocking on the door. And he is in. Touchdown, Miami. A great play there. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Dolphins are in for 6. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how we're going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
Extra point put through by Succop, and that makes the score 14-7. Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. This is taken at the 3. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And here now the offense heading back out there. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
A really nice gain of 25 yards. So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 46. Roethlisberger, it's complete to Brown, right side. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And he gets it down to the 32. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
Hurry up, let's go!
Ingram again, a first down carry. And room there to work it inside the 25. Just what you want on a first down run, call it 8 yards, and it's 2nd and 2. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. On 2nd down, Roethlisberger. Throw left side, complete to Moss. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. Two minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to Atlanta right after this timeout. Roethlisberger now after the pick on the last drive, 3 for 3 to start this drive. It's 1st and 10. This is Ingram on 1st and 10. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
A lot of people call the toss a probing play to see what they can get against the defense, to see how they adjust and react. Their probing's working pretty well. That was a very nice run.
Hurry up, let's go!
On 2nd down, Ingram. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up third and five.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action and hit them over the top.
To throw here, Roethlisberger. And that is incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
Field goal forthcoming for Steven Hauschka. This just a 24-yard attempt. And Hauschka's kick is good. And they'll cut the lead back down to four now at 14-10. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to three.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And, yeah, points went against them. That feels a whole lot better running off the field.
Out comes the Dolphin offense now as they get set to take over here. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
First down throw for Mariota. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. The linebacker, Telvin Smith, able to get a hand on it there. Defensively, celebration time because they finally forced an incompletion. He was perfect throwing the ball to that point.
Yeah, but from his viewpoint, they didn't force the incompletion. He just missed. That's how hot he is right now, and that's how he wants to continue to throw the ball.
A second down throw here for Mariota. He's going to rifle one, and he fires one that's intercepted. John Johnson with the INT, and his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
After the interception, here's Roethlisberger, flushed out right. It's caught by Mark Ingram, giving 30 yards there.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse, still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down.
It's never a bad idea to try and get it to Antonio Brown, but it must be a little bit of the Madden curse going on for our cover athlete here. Hasn't been able to get that elite separation that we're used to seeing from him.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. And before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Again, they'll run with Ingram. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes this one down to the 15. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. Now a play fake here on first down. And Davis with it left side. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. A gain of 6 there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. Now a timeout. 7 seconds left in the first half. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And Hauschka's kick is good. And the lead is down to one now at 14-13. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. The Dolphins in front, and they'll be in possession of the football first as the second half gets started. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Out comes the Dolphins now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ballgame.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show him one thing, hit him with something else.
And he'll be out of bounds up near midfield at the 49. His fifth catch tonight, and it's good for a first down. Fifth catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. Used to be occasional, right, safety valve. Throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. On second down, here's Mixon. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
And avoids the contact by sliding. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Dolphins first down. The last drive, remember, similar situation. He forced a ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar.
The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Zach Brown. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Go, go, go. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Play action. It's Roethlisberger. He's going to air one out. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And they finally do get him, but not before he reaches the 27. It's a big play, Roethlisberger to Brown, and even 50 yards. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down. Got a man, it's Brown. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Now Roethlisberger to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Moss. The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Pass complete, but no gain.
No yards.
Yeah.
So you file that as unsuccessful.
Yeah, you do, don't you? Except on the stats, throwing the ball.
Get a completion.
You get a catch.
Yeah.
But still,
no yardage.
Okay.
Because his third field goal now with a ball game, and they needed his leg. This last one gives him the lead.
It's been a back-and-forth kind of a game, hasn't it? Now you got to tell your defense, guys, need you to make this stand up because we got the momentum going in the right direction, but we need you to make sure we carry it home.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Dolphins' offense now ready to go back out onto the field. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know what, a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
And he's taken down deep in their territory. It's a big play there for Miami, and even 60 yards.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he's able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. A great effort there. His second touchdown of the night, and the Dolphins are in for six. Well, that was a quick hitter drive. They had the huge play to get him down near the goal line, and then they run it in. I don't know that the defense ever had a chance to catch their breath.
A lot of the time now, when we see people hit big plays, and each team defines a big play their own way, 10, 15-yard gains. In this case, it was a huge gain. They often want to hurry up and go right away. Keep the momentum going, hit them again, and I think we just saw that there. The second play resulted in pay dirt.
Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive in with a kick other than the extra point. That's it.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Again on second and 10, it's Roethlisberger. That's brought in by Davis over the middle. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. Roethlisberger now, five straight completions here in this second half, first and 10. A 10th carry here for Mark Ingram. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Now Roethlisberger rolling to his left. He goes underneath to Ingram. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
Oh, no, he lost the football.
Wow. That ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover.
On the counter, Ingram down to the 25. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Here's Roethlisberger. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
I know for us it's fun, and it's not so much fun for the rookie receivers when we see them coming into the league and we're good at training camps. You see them working on getting 2 feet down instead of one. But the best ones train in college trying to get two down instead of one, so the transition's a little bit less. In this case, though, wasn't able to complete it anyway.
On third down, Roethlisberger. He dumps it down to Ingram. Ingram's got the first down and more. And down to the 7 yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and broad. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time. And, Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line, because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines, as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
They'll look to run with Ingram, and he's going to get this back to the 3 yard line and no further. Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
They come out here in the eye. Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is third and three. Brown, the lone receiver, left. On third and goal, Roethlisberger. And it falls incomplete after almost being intercepted. A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down. Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on fourth and goal. They're running. Ingram. And he's not going to get in. They stop him at the one. Ingram denied on fourth and goal. And the Dolphins celebrate their goal line stand. The Dolphins offense now heads back on the field. Their defense forced the turnover on downs. They've got the lead. They're in good shape, but can't go into a shell here, right? Still got to be careful.
Yeah, because they're still a long way away from kneel down time. So they've got to work on getting first downs. Keep the sticks moving, right? Keep the clock going. And above all, ball security. Don't turn it over.
Throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete.
And there was a good opportunity to just went awry there. A drop pass. I guess that's why they call them running backs and not catching backs.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Throwing again, Mariota on second and 10. And he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game changer there in this second half. Instead, it's third down.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got a lead, you've got to protect it, and he's taking chances putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. He may try and run for this. Gain of 9 that time on the scramble. 1 yard shy of the marker, and it brings up fourth. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. And here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Working out of the gun, Mariota. Open man, it's Vernon Davis. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. That one a backbreaker as they wind up converting there on fourth. Mariota now a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. First and 10. Mixon with a first down carry. And he'll take this one up over the 20 to the 21-yard line. Tackle made there by Zach Brown.
Well, they picked up a little bit of yardage there. And now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Mariota now. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. Not a whole lot of room to run. Gets it to the 35 after showcasing the great move. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. As the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in the fourth. Victory very likely now for the Dolphins as they take a knee here. Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third. Mariota with a knee to the ground, and that should be it.
We've seen this offense go for it on fourth down already on this drive. I wonder if they'll go for it again.
I certainly wouldn't rule it out with these guys. Here's Brad Wing now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. Well, partner, even though my phone alarm failed me this morning and I missed our AM workout, we still made it through this thing together, didn't we?
Well, you always know I need extra workouts just to keep up with you. So it doesn't matter, but thanks for sharing a booth and thanks for being our quarterback.
Yeah, you're the quarterback. Always a pleasure, my friend.